A pointer is a variable that contains the memory address of another variable. We declare a pointer as we would any other variable, except that we prefix its name with an asterisk. The data type used determines what type of memory it will point to. If we now create a variable of that same type, we can make our pointer point to it by prefixing that variable with an ampersand to retrieve its address. This ampersand is called the address of operator. Our pointer p now contains the memory address of the variable I. To get the address stored in the pointer, we simply type its name, and to get the actual value stored in that address, we prefix the name with an asterisk, known as the dereference operator. Same thing when writing to the pointer. Without the asterisk, the pointer is assigned a new memory address, and with the asterisk, it will update the actual value of the variable it points to. If we create another pointer and assign it to P, it will then get a copy of P's memory address. Sometimes, however, we may want a pointer that can point to another pointer. This is done by declaring a pointer with two asterisks and then assigning it the address of the pointer we wanted to reference. This way, when the address in P changes, R can follow that change. Typing R now gives the address of P, dereferencing R gives the address of I, and dereferencing it again gives the value of I. One of the main usages of pointers is to allocate dynamic memory. Until now, we have only had as much memory available as we have declared for our variables. If we need any additional memory, we have to use the new operator. This operator allows for allocation of global memory, which can only be accessed through pointers. An important thing to know about dynamic memory is that it will not be released like the rest of the program's memory when it is no longer needed. Instead, we have to manually release it with the delete keyword when we're done using it. Forgetting to delete memory that we'll allocate it with a new keyword will give our program memory leaks, and that memory will stay allocated even when the program shuts down.